information tonight regarding how new F-35 fighter jets will impact the neighbors. Good evening. I'm George Mallet.
And I'm Stephanie Gorin. This is a story WPTZ first broke last night. Tonight, the commander of the fighter wing and the leader of a new office designed to seamlessly transition to the new jet sit down exclusively with WPTZ's David Charnes.
There's a lot going on. 6 years is going to go by very quickly.
18 F-35s will arrive in Burlington in 2020. But Colonel T.J. Jackman and Lieutenant Colonel Chris Caputo are already hard at work.
We are aggressively pursuing every option we need to do to make sure that no topic is left unaddressed.
The Guard's mitigation plan, obtained first by WPTZ Thursday, lays out a course for a smooth landing. Issue number one, noise and how it'll impact neighbors.
We're concerned as well. I mean, I live by the airport. I have friends that live by the airport. We're all part of the local community, and we're absolutely committed to working with the local community to the max extent possible.
The plan now, fly the F-35 like its predecessor, the F-16. The planes will stay at higher altitudes and avoid nighttime flights when possible.
We're hoping that you'll see even less of an impact on the community than the information that came out in the EIS.
That document indicates about 8,000 more people around the airport will be affected by military operations. But Jackman and Caputo say it's their mission to work directly with communities to mitigate as much as possible. And an F-35 could fly in Vermont airspace as a preview sometime before the first plane arrives.
I am confident that we're going to have an F-35 in here.
Other plans include about $5 million in facility upgrades. Firefighters will be trained to respond specifically to an F-35 incident. And in 2016, maintenance and operations workers will be sent to other bases to train. It's all part of the Guard's next assignment.
The F-35 is just that next step, and it means that the Green Mountain Boys will have that opportunity to continue to contribute to the defense of the United States for another 40, 50 years.
The F-35s are set to land here in June of 2020. In Burlington, David Charnes, WPTZ News Channel 5.